Hello, this is Brad, and I am with Mid-Continent Public Library. Today, I am going to show you how to screen mirror with your iPhone or iPad. Screen mirroring, or casting, is when you project the screen of your smartphone, tablet, or computer to a larger screen, such as a TV or a projector. Whatever is displayed on your phone's screen will be visible on your TV. There are several instances in which you may want to do this. Maybe you found a video on your phone that you want to show to multiple people, or you just want to see it on a larger screen. And once my device is screen mirroring, I don't have to do anything different. I would just interact with my phone in the same way that I normally would. The only difference is whatever is displayed on my screen will then be screen mirrored onto the larger screen. This could be a video you find on YouTube. It could also be a video on a streaming service as well. Any website that you navigate to or app that you open will be displayed on your TV. So when I project video from my phone to my TV, the sound is going to come through the TV, not my phone. And the application or the website you are visiting doesn't even necessarily have to be or video. You could project anything you want to. I could show photos that are on my iPhone, on my TV, by using screen mirroring. And when I project video, the audio is going to play through my TV. So maybe I just want to do this to project a music application so I can listen to music through these speakers on my TV. But I could check anything I want to. I could check the weather from a weather app I have on my phone. Maybe I even want to read an ebook on the big screen. And since we have that audio going through our TV, maybe I want to listen to an e-audiobook through my TV. Any application that I can open on my phone, I can then project to my TV. Or if I was trying to project at work, maybe I want to project a presentation onto a projector or a TV at work. I could do that as well. In order to screen mirror, I need to make sure that my smart TV is hooked up to the internet. This would just be my home Wi-Fi connection. And then the iPhone that I am trying to screen mirror from also needs to be connected to that same Wi-Fi connection. There is no Bluetooth involved in this process. My phone is going to talk to my TV through that shared internet connection. And if I don't use the smart TV function on my TV, maybe I use a Roku or an Apple TV or an Amazon Fire Stick. I just need to make sure that that is connected both to the TV, of course, and to Wi-Fi. And then I will make sure my iPhone is connected to that same Wi-Fi connection. So let's go ahead and make sure that we are connected to the internet. Here on my iPad, I will tap Settings. And I will go to Wi-Fi within the Settings area. And I will ensure that I am connected to my home Wi-Fi, the same one that my TV is connected to, because that is how these two devices are going to communicate. Once I am connected to that Wi-Fi, I can close out of Settings. I need to make sure that my TV is on. If you have a Roku, it may look like this. And then I'm going to swipe down towards the center of my screen from the top corner of my iPad screen, and I should see this menu. And I want to select this button that has two rectangles that are stacked in front of each other. That is the screen mirroring button. And if I was on an iPhone, I would swipe up from the bottom. And then I can see that same two rectangles that are stacked in front of each other. And tapping this button will open up my screen mirroring menu. This is going to show me all the potential devices that I could connect to through screen mirroring. If your smart TV is connected to the same internet that your phone is connected to, you will likely see it on this menu. It could say LG or Samsung or Vizio. And then likely after that, there will be a big long number that is the model number of the TV. So it could be beneficial to know what that is if you don't want to just do trial and error to find that out. if you use a Roku or an Apple TV or another wireless device, you would likely see that appear in the menu. You might have to kind of suss out exactly which connection you are wanting to connect to. Once you have decided which connection it is you are trying to connect to, you can go and tap on it. My TV screen is going to display this AirPlay code, more than likely. And so then on my iPad, I will need to enter that code to connect my iPad to this TV. And once I enter that, I can project the screen from my iPad. So I will continue to use my iPad like I normally would. I could go to a website, and it will be projected onto this screen. And just like I showed you earlier, I could watch a video. I could watch any various streaming site that I have a subscription to by going to their website. Or if I have the app downloaded, I could access it through that. And you know, it's really whatever I want to do. I could read a magazine through one of the library's resources if I wanted to. And to close out, I swipe again from the top right corner to the center of my screen, tap on that screen mirroring button again, and I should see an option to stop screen mirroring. And then I would be disconnected. And some apps come with a built-in casting button, so you may have accidentally casted before. Here in this Photos application, I can see at the very top I have this button. That is a screen mirroring button. I also have one here if I'm looking at a specific photo. It will ask for permission to cast to local devices. I will need to allow it to do so. And then I should see a list of options available, if there are any. And I could cast from this app. I don't need to bring that menu open by swiping on my device. And within YouTube, I also have this as well. So there are different apps that have this. Each app is going to need permission to cast. And then I should see options available that I can cast to show this specific application. And even if I am watching a video, I might see this button appear. So if you see that, just know that that is what that is for. It's for screencasting. If you were at work and you were trying to connect to a projector, you will also need to make sure that you have your projector turned on. And there are a couple different setups that you might encounter. I'm going to show you a couple different ones and show you how to prepare your projector to screen mirror with an iPad or an iPhone. First, I want to go to Controls, and I just want to make sure that my projector is on. So I'm going to tap Projector On. In some instances, that will also bring the projector screen down. If it does not, I would look for a button that says something like Screen Down, as I see here, and that will bring your screen down. So our projector is on, our screen is down. I'm going to tap this Video button. And now we are going to control where the source of video is coming from. I am going to tap this Apple TV button. Sometimes the projectors will say Roku or Apple TV, but they might encompass both wireless setups. Basically, it just means that you are connecting wirelessly and not through an HDMI cable. In this situation, I need to make sure my projector is on. I have two projectors that I'm screen mirroring to here, so I'll turn both of those on. Make sure I select the button to bring the screens down. Find my video button, and then I'm going to select Roku in this instance. Here's a different setup. All I need to do is make sure I bring my screen down, and then on my display panel over here, I want to make sure that I turn the display on and then select Apple TV. Again, even if I'm connecting through a Roku, I might have a button that says Apple TV. Once I have got that ready, I will swipe down to the middle of my screen, select my screen mirroring button, and then I should be good to project at work. And so that is how you can screen mirror with your iPhone. Next time you're trying to share a video, you don't have to have a bunch of people staring at your phone. Just cast it to the TV and you can all enjoy. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to our MCPLMO YouTube channel. This has been Brad. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a great day.